Well, this was in the ground in the beach probably about 2.5 months ago. And a friend of mine, it wasn't me who found it, a friend of mine sort of phoned me up and said, "Oh, Steve, I've just seen the edge of a vertebra." This is what you could see, just this edge here, okay? And this was the sort of edge of the shale block. He said, "I think there's a bit of a fish in there." And he said, "I found some other things, but if you want to come down, we'll have a go at collecting it." And so when I went down, I could see the edge of the vertebra, and I could see those ribs coming off there. I could just see the little dots where the ribs were. So I said, "I'll tell you what, it's going the right way. We think so. The head's up this way, because don't forget we can't see any of this at all right? This is all covered with matrix." So basically, we cut round the shale, and it came out, I think, as a natural fault across here. Can you see that sort of line there? And I think one across here. So it came out in three pieces, but it butted up lovely because it wasn't broken. It was just natural sort of cracks in it. So what I did then was actually cover up the underside, or the top side of it, was because that would be under there would be the top side. Plastered that, waited it all dried, and then actually developed the underside, which we see here. Started off at this end. You can see all this yellowish material. This is all sort of soft tissue running over the tops of the sort of bones. But what it's yielded, because we've got another one of these, is actually some superb preservation of that sort of dorsal fin there and these fin supports. On any of the thicker material I've seen describing this particular species of fish, they're not present. These pelvic fin supports here, again, not seen. And you can also see even the intestinal tract that runs up through there. You can follow that right up through. You've got some black organic material there, which is probably the residue of some sort of tissue. The pectoral fin, which normally is never preserved in this sort of detail, you can see it goes right to the tip of the fin there, right to that sharp point that comes back here. So there's the two pectoral fins. Here you can see the big bony ring around the eye, which on all the specimens we've got and from the specimens I've seen described, that's not yet present as well. So all in all, although we've not got the tail, this is possibly, or I would say probably with a great authority, that it's the best preserved that fish specimen called Pachythrissops that's been found to date. Now we've got, I think we've got four of these. Since I've got this one out, there's another one. Now with all of them, we've never found the tail, because there's another one there. Okay, same species. Okay, same species. So that's the same as this, although it's slightly bigger. You can see the vertebra much bigger. Preservation not quite so good. You can't see the sort of pelvic fin or pectoral fin supports or anything like that. When I collected this, we'd left some fish material there because we collected so much. We've got to transport this back up to the vehicles, and it's too heavy. So we'd left something else, which actually was this. And I'll show you there, if you can get that in there, Valerie. Look, it's actually the tail of one of these. This is the first tail we've ever found of this species of fish. Okay, you can see the supports on the sort of tail, the base of the tail. The tail would have gone right up there, but of course it's slightly rotted, so it's not that well preserved, but that's the first tail we've got. Now, since finding all this and prepping it's only 2 weeks ago that we went and collected another one, and we've got the tail of it. So we hope and we think it's in the same bed as this, so the preservation should be just as good or maybe even better. So all the time there's new material coming out.